There have been plenty of apocalypses over the course of history, too many perhaps. Western modernity itself is born out of an apocalypse, the conquest of Americas and the Holocaust of the New World. And it has long since reached its end, its consummation in an infinite series of holocausts of human and non-human beings. If we feel lost today, it is because we became used to perpetrate our present. Our future was ahead of us, already mastered and increasingly progressive. But now that this age seems to be exhausted, its end reveals the need to decolonize time from the empire or our present, with its belief that everything will be decided by us, that everything has to do with us, and thus to respond to us. Futures swarm. They become multitudes when freed from the tyranny of a unique totalitarian present, which has dared to englobe the time to come.
So how do we decolonize time if we know that daily, every day, day by day, for centuries, for decades, a system is being imposed on us, a system which is called capitalism, which is probably the most successful system in colonizing time? How do we decolonize from a system which is the most successful colonizer of time in world history? Ever since the invention of the mechanical clock in the Middle Ages, the time of progress, so-called progress, is intrinsically linked to the expansion of capitalism. And this idea of progress sustains itself through a belief that time is something which moves on a kind of linear, in a linear way from one point to the other point. This is this concept of history, which is also being sustained itself through capitalism, through the last centuries. The current pandemic and the so-called COVID-19 crisis, besides accelerating further the colonization of time by capitalism through remote work, remote learning, remote dating, remote loving, through this kind of digitalization of our very beings, this crisis has at the same time served as a sort of crack in this colonization of time. Suddenly, we became aware that we are not only faced by synchronicities, but we are also faced by heterochronicities. The apocalypse already happened. And what we are living in is an age where we are facing a profound planetary recomposition. What is the apocalypse? The apocalypse in its original Greek meaning is a revelation. It means that something is being unveiled, something is being revealed. And our current revelation, our current apocalypse is the following one. The current apocalypse can be summed up by three E, by the letter E, by three E. And it stands for the following. It stands for exploitation, extraction, and expansion. And these three E of capitalism are leading to the ultimate E, namely extinction. What we need today, not only in order to orientate ourselves in these quite post-apocalyptic times, but also in order to act, is a new sort of political eschatology. It is a sort of political eschatology which was already founded by the great but underestimated philosopher Günther Anders, who was warning us that there is no kingdom to come, unlike the previous Christian, but also Marxist and many other eschatologies, that there is no kingdom to come. What is going to come is only an apocalypse without kingdom, a sort of naked apocalypse. Or as Kafka would have said, the Messiah will only come when he is no longer necessary. He will only come on the day after his arrival. And this is perhaps a way for us to learn to stop worrying and to love the apocalypse. It is not something that will happen. It is something that already happened. It was unveiled by the pandemic. It was unveiled by the centuries of colonialism and capitalist expansion and extraction. it is being unveiled and it is being revealed day by day by the destruction of environment and the destruction of other species. It is now in the 21st century, this apocalypse being unveiled by the collision between the nuclear age and the climate crisis. So how do we decolonize time itself? First, we have to start by switching off the clocks, metaphorically, but also quite literally. And perhaps instead of the ultimate E, extinction, we can reach another E, namely evolution, which is the biggest revolution in the universe itself.